Now Splatoon 2 is finally here, and of course we're excited for it. But today, we will be looking at the very first game of the series. It was created by Nintendo Entertainment Analysis and Development in late 2013. The team had thought of over 70 game ideas, but decided to focus on a game involving inking turf. During development, they also took inspiration from the Mario games, which you can clearly see. It was an experimental game, so they came up with a ton of different ideas. Before they went with the Inklings, they thought of characters like Mario, robots, rabbits, and even Macho Men. So the game in general went through a number of changes, and you know what that means. Unused and beta content. And Splatoon certainly had some stuff. Let's start with unused outfits. With a game that includes fashion elements, it is to be expected for some of the gear to be left out. Currently, 4 pieces of gear go completely unused, and 6 others are minor cosmetic alterations of used pieces of gear. Most unreleased pieces of gear shown here have bomb range up as an ability and 0 stars, both most likely placeholders. First up, the Varsity Hoodie. This is a grey and brown hoodie with a white house logo on the top left, complete with black buttons and a hood. Early screenshots show that it was displayed in the Jellyfresh store in the beta, but the final game shows the camo zip hoodie instead. Its name suggests it could have been an early version of the existing Varsity jacket or a completely different item. And now, it isn't in the game at all. Which is kind of disappointing, since it does look good.
Next, Shirt Stravaganza. Seen being worn in a few early battle videos, several adverts, and even seen in the 18th Sunken Scroll. It may have been replaced by the Baby Jelly shirt in the final game, but it is still a mystery. Now, all the other shirts only had some minor changes, for example a different color, so that's not too interesting. But they also dumped headgear, and there are some interesting ones among them. Like the warrior headdress. This one shows up in the background of cooler heads, although covered by the shop text and has tenacity as an ability. It may not have been released due to connection to Native American culture, you know how such things go nowadays. There is also a model for a head version. It would have been a cool addition to the game and it looks gorgeous. But sadly enough, identity politics kind of ruined this. Now, they also dumped some super tactical stuff, called stealth goggles. While the stealth goggles are in the final game by now as they came with a bigger update in August 2015, they already were in the files as the game was released. This is an early icon of it. However, the night vision goggles received a green glow from the lenses in the final version. And there is also the Elite Octoling goggles, which is different from the stealth one. These are worn by their elite troops, and you can buy them at cooler heads for 9,800 cash. It would have been a cool treasure for defeating the Octolings, but nope, that never happened. However, there is more about the Octolings that wasn't used, and this is actually quite a big deal since it was a completely new feature. Normally, you can only play as Inklings, since that's your team essentially. However, Nintendo had a different plan. Octolings have 2 separate models, one for the enemy that appears in the single player, and an unused one that functions as an alternate player model for the Inklings. Hacking the goggles off the enemy model shows that they have Inkling eyes as placeholders, while the player models use unique ones not found anywhere else. Sometimes, the player model can fail to load and use either garbage textures or Inkling eyes. The player model has ink color changing hair and it received changes in the updates, most notably adding a mouth for use in losing animations. The Octolings have their own unique version of the Kraken special, fan-dubbed the Octokraken. It is very similar to the regular Kraken, only with its tentacles curling up instead of pointing down.
So they were planning to add the Octoling as a fully playable character by the looks of it, but it doesn't end there. Official artwork of an Octoling without goggles was published on both the Japanese Twitter and American Tumblr Squid Research Center promo media, which are even more pieces of evidence that they wanted to put them in the final product. But what was their plan? Well, since a playable model is found in the single player campaign, it could be that there was a good guy storyline and a bad guy one. Or maybe you played as an Octoling in some parts of the story. What it comes down to is that it must have been a part of the single player campaign. Now, there's also something weird in the files, but not the ones of Splatoon. This one is found in the files of Mario Maker. Yes, a significant amount of early Splatoon content also ended up being left unused in those files and for some reason ended up there. But there is one weapon hidden in those files that isn't seen in the game that is absolutely amazing to say the least and would have made a lot of people happy. A real snub revolver. And since this is such a classic and iconic weapon, it would have been really cool to see in the game. Not a lot is known about it. It's only found in the Mario Maker files and not in the ones of Splatoon. And besides that, we don't really know how all of this ended up in the files of a Mario game. Sure, they were both Wii U games, but they were both completely different. Besides that, Mario Maker is a 2D game and Splatoon a 3D one. This is an enormous difference. But we will never know why this happened. Ah well, Splatoon 2 is finally here, so now we can start having fun with that. And maybe there's a ton of beta content for us to explore in the future. We will just have to wait and see. Hey everyone, I'll be going to Summer in the City in London this year together with my editor, Commonwealth Realm and Thiefbug. The event is from the 4th to the 6th of August in the London XL, and we'll even have our own Zelda panel on Sunday, so come to the event and hang out with us! Thanks for watching everybody, I hope you enjoyed. If you want to watch more videos, click the annotations on the screen right now, and be sure to subscribe, because we release a video every Friday, and you don't want to miss it!